What we're going to be doing is looking at, as the topic is, how to design and maintain and work with food forests or forest gardens, which is an example of how permaculture design is implemented. Permaculture design was originally started as an idea of creating sustainable food systems, some way of making agriculture more sustainable. And what we've learned over the years is that a process that can be used to design food systems along ecological lines, really permaculture attempts to mimic nature. We figure that living systems have been here on Earth for close to 4 billion years. They've figured a lot of stuff out. And if we can learn what it is that nature does to be so successful at what she does, then our systems are going to get a lot better, a lot more sustainable. I guess a way that you can think about it is that when we build stuff, it starts to fall apart the minute we finish it. It's sort of like that effect of driving the new car out of the dealership. It loses 20% of its value as soon as you get out into the street. And that's kind of the way most of our systems do. You build a house, and immediately the paint starts to fade in the sun, and the shingles start to buckle, and when it rains, moss grows on it, and it leaks, and all that sort of thing. In natural systems, in living systems, when it rains on a forest, the forest just gets lusher and greener, right? When the sun shines on a forest, it doesn't peel and fade, it gets lusher and greener and better, and it grows. Somehow nature has figured out how to take these forces that for us are damaging, are difficult, are destructive forces, and nature has figured out how to take those and turn them into productive forces, things that make their systems better. Nature has figured out how to do that. So in other words, if we were designing houses the way nature designs her living systems, then when it rained on your house, it would like pop out a new wing or something like that, right? It would use that as a beneficial force of some kind. So that's essentially what permaculture design is how do we take these forces of nature and run them through systems that turn them into great things, just the way sunlight falling on a plant causes it to grow. Start with observation is at the top of every list of everything we do in permaculture. You can't start messing with something until you understand what's going on. So, and I think you've all heard this old gardener's adage about wait 1 year, which of course no one ever does. I mean, you can't wait a year, but it's a nice idea to go through the whole year of cycles and figure out what is going to change over time and what works. We accelerate that by talking to neighbors, reading books, you know, that sort of thing. But it's so important to understand what's there. We love to get in and just mess around, you know, but we're always going to run into trouble doing that. But one of the things we talk about in permaculture is the zone system. And that is simply the idea that if, say, this is your house, and say, like, I'll just draw the place that I used to live, front door there, back door there, and we had a barn up here and a parking area here in the driveway. We had a path going here, and we had a flat space here. What the zone system says is the stuff you use the most often or that needs you should go closest to where you are the most often. So what we wound up doing was planting our annual vegetables along here because I walked this way several times a day, or at least once a day, and this was the place where we hung out because it was the main flat space below the house. So this was zone one because I was there every day. Things that needed my attention every day, I put there. One day, a farmer from across the river came over and said, I'd love to give you guys a tour of my farm. And so we went across the river, and he took us to his house and described how, you know, he pointed out some jaguar footprints going right in front of his house the night before a jaguar had gone by. And it was this amazing place. There are trogon birds sitting in the trees and morpho butterflies with this like 10-inch wingspans flapping by, and it was this unbelievable jungle. It just was this tangled mass of craziness, you know, tropical jungle. And he said, how do you like my farm? I'm like looking around, just, this is jungle, this is, you know, jaguars, wild birds. Just had no idea what was going on. It just was this, you know, it was this, I mean, it was looked like that, just this. And he called it his farm. And then as I looked, I realized, okay, that's a mango tree up there. I started being able to pick things out. My eyes started to get used to it. So first I could see there was a mango, and then, oh, there's some bananas over there, and then there's some coffee bushes over here, and then I realized, wait, that's citrus over there, and those are some medicinal plants, and those are useful timber trees, and those are nitrogen-fixing trees, and that's a tamarind tree over there, which both has an edible pod and it's a nitrogen-fixing tree. And then he pointed out Ignacio came out and he stood next to this cacao tree that had a vanilla bean. That's a vanilla bean, which is a type of orchid, twining up it. So it's chocolate and vanilla mixed together, a great, great little guild. And I realized I was looking at his farm. It's just that it looked and behaved just like a natural tropical forest. But everything in it were things that he and his ancestors had planted over the years. But it was so nicely dovetailed in with the ecosystem that jaguars could walk through it, and trogons and other amazing birds could hang out in the trees, and morpho butterflies, and